Greetings, friends! So today I'm gonna do something a little bit different for me. These kinds of things I think exist all over YouTube, but I'm gonna do a top 10 kind of tutorial. If there's anything that this quarantine has taught me, it's the magnitude and power and endless scrolling and rabbit holing that is TikTok. If you don't know what TikTok is, then you're probably like over the age of 53 and don't have young people in your life at all. As of this recording, I don't have a TikTok account because it scares me. As a teacher, I think it would probably be the easiest way for my students to find me, and therefore I'm not going there. So as of this recording, you can't follow me on TikTok, but who knows what happens? I could just throw in the towel. I mean, the world is coming to an end anyways, so who cares about your online persona? But I thought I would do some TikTok viral video songs. And the reason I'm doing it is because maybe you agree. After you watch a viral trend over the course of time, you have listened to the same 15 seconds of that song over and over again, and it gets stuck in your head real good. So what I do when I get stuff stuck in my head is I try to figure it out on my good old ukulele, and I thought maybe a couple of you would be helped by this as well. Maybe you can impress your quarantine buddies. If you're having some kind of FaceTime party, you can impress your friends that you know how to play a couple chords to a 15-second loop that plays on TikTok all the time. Now, disclaimer is that I have never done a tutorial with chords presented on the screen before, so please excuse me if any kind of technical snafu thing happens. I'm gonna try to make sure that you can see my hands and the chords at the same time, but it's a work in progress. These will go in no particular order. I might start with the easiest one. We'll see what happens. But here we go. Top 10 trending TikTok songs on ukulele. So just as a heads up, these are all of the chords that you will need to know. For all of these songs.
Ooh.
And those chords are, in alphabetical order, A, A minor, A major 7, A minor 7. That's everyone's favorite chord, right? B flat, B minor, C and C7, good old D, E flat, E minor, E minor 7, E7, F, F sharp 7. Don't be scared, you can do it. G, G7, and G major 7, my personal favorite. Okay, so now we're gonna start with the easiest one because it's got one chord, at least the part that everyone knows, which is literally just oops.
Oops, my heart went oops, yeah.
And you've probably seen this one if you're on TikTok ever. You've seen about 1,000 of them.
Oops, my heart went oops.
So in the original recording that they use for the track in TikTok, it's an E flat chord. So literally all you have to do is just strum that and you've got your first one. You can just say, oops, my heart went, and then it goes to whatever the heck it was before. I don't know what that other song is because I don't pay attention after that because people trying to feel so fancy about themselves. Weird flex, bro. I mean, we get it. Everybody wears sweatpants and has messy hair in the morning. There is an actual entire song for this, which is way more complicated, and I'm making an entirely separate video for that. So if you want to make sure that you see that and you want the chords for the entire song, make sure that you hit the subscribe button over here in the corner and then hit the dingling bell up there, and you'll get notified for when I post that after this one, and you'll get all the chords for the oops song. Now moving on to number two. The number two song is, now I'm probably gonna say this all wrong, called La 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 La.
When I popped off, then your girl gave me just a little bit of-
and it says it's by Y2KBBNO Money Sign. Now, I'm sure those things mean things to people. They don't mean anything to me. But this one is pretty simple because it's basically kind of just a bass line. And I don't believe this is the original key. I'm gonna check. I may be referring to some chord charts here throughout because 10 songs is a lot of songs, you guys. So La 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 is actually in the key of D, but I found that it was kind of a weird pattern to play on ukulele with the shifts that you have to make in your hand position. So I moved it up to A. I think I moved it to A. So for this one, you're going to need these chords. So you're gonna be going from A to B flat, to C to B flat. And the pattern is a little bit different than just like a standard four beats to the measure. So you're gonna have your A, your B flat, your C, your B flat, and your A. And it kind of moves at that kind of like pace. So you have an A, B flat, a C, B flat, A. And it has sort of a Spanish feel actually when you just play that part of it. I feel like I'm on cobblestone roads in the middle of Sevilla. So you have the A, the B flat, the C, the B flat. So you've got this sort of, when I popped off, then your girl gave me just a little bit of lockjaw. Baby, so cold from the north, from the Canada, bankroll he's so low. I got nothing else that I can withdraw, so I don't know the words, but that's how it goes. Number three. Ooh, number three is another one of my favorites. So this one tends to get used to create sort of like whimsical romantic videos amongst teener tweener couples.
Go to bed, I'll make a cup of coffee for your head. I'll get you up and going out of bed.
Yeah. I don't want to fall asleep.
It's got sort of a winsome, ethereal quality to it. So this is Deathbed, which is by an artist named Pao Fu. So the chords that you need to know for Deathbed are C, C major 7, A minor, and F. And it's really simple. This may be one of like the simplest, most traditionally able to be done, and may even originally be done on ukulele in the recording. Now, this is the original key that it is in. It's in C, which is like one of the easiest first keys that you ever learn to play on ukulele. So if you've been playing for a while, this is gonna be super easy. If you're a beginner, this is still gonna be super easy. Your strum pattern doesn't need to be too complicated. You can just go down on those quarter notes, or you can do a good old down, down, up, down, up. I think they do that in the original recording. We have a C, and then we have the C major 7. So you just slide it on up to the next fret. You can either use that same finger or move to the 3 finger to go over. And then that's gonna be your A minor and then F. So you have C, C major 7, A minor, and F. And so then you just add that strum pattern in, and I'm gonna do the down up one, add the lyrics to it, and you've got yourself a nice whimsical TikTok ditty.
Don't stay awake too long, don't go to bed, I'll make a cup of coffee for your head, get you up and going out of bed.
Now they usually end it right about there. I may do a full version of this later on, so make sure that you subscribe and stay tuned for that. That was number three, Deathbed. How you doing? You holding up? You hanging in there? We're moving on to number four. Number four is Chinese New Year, which is by an artist named Sales. Sales? I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm going to assume that it is Sales. So Chinese New Year is a really, really good one because it kind of challenges people. I guess the trend is you run around until you find some ridiculous spot to do the dance right on the kick of the chorus, which is like always just some like weird simple dance, but for some reason it's funny every single time. So this is Chinese New Year. Now Chinese New Year, you are going to need to know D and G for the chorus, and then you're gonna need to know B minor, E minor, and A for the little part that comes before the chorus. So there's always that, the part that comes before, which is where they're running around. So that's the B minor, the E minor, and the A. And so we'll go over that part first because it can be a little dicey. Okay, so the order of operations is that you need to do an E minor, which is going to kind of give you that kickstart into the key. Then you don't really start singing until you get to the B minor. So next we have our E minor, and then we have our B minor, bar that top part. Don't try to use different fingers. So B minor, and then it goes up to A, and then it's gonna cut back into the E minor, and then it's gonna go to the B minor again, and then A, and now we're all ready for the chorus, which is just a D, and then a G. It's really easy. The vocal part of that part that comes before the chorus is kind of weird. So the timing of those first chords, the intro part, is E, 2, 3, 4, B minor, A, and B minor, and B minor, and A, and D. And then you go into the chorus from there. I'm gonna do a down, down, up strumming pattern, but I'm gonna use a chuck in there because if you watch my channel, you know that's what I'm comfortable with. Plus it works for this song. I'm trying to make these ukulele arrangements to be as similar to the actual recording as possible, so as to impress your friends as much as possible. We'll do this one with just the chords first, and then we'll try it again with the lyrics, because that way you'll get a better feel for how it flows. So we have just the chords to play first. 1, 2, 3, 4, E minor, B minor, B minor, B minor, A, and D, and G, and D, and G. Now, the chorus actually keeps going and going and going, but that's where the videos usually stop, is around the first G, the D, G, and that's it. So now we're gonna try it with the words, which makes it a little bit harder. So we have 1, 2, ready, and.
No, I can't, no, I can't, no, I can't, where to get out of here? I see you at the movies, I see you with your lipstick on, I'm looking at the cosmos.
And so it just keeps going and going and going through that chorus. Now, if you want to try playing this with the song, like the original recording, those are the original key, the chords for the key. And this is actually a really fun one to play with the recording. And it starts at about the 42nd mark if you want to try playing it with the song. That's where they snippeted it for TikTok. So I don't know what number was that. Was that 4? Was that 4? Which means we're moving on to number 5. We're already halfway through. I don't know how long this video is going to take, but we're halfway through it. Now, the next one, number 5, is Friendships, which is by Pascal Latoublin. I don't know how to say names. Pascal Latoublin. This one is really, really addicting, as in it will run in your head all day, and it's used primarily for footwork tutorials. Maybe I'll put some links down in the bottom to some of the best ones that I've seen, or links to the original tracks or whatever, but this one is crazy earworm quality. Now basically what we're going to be doing is only playing the bass line portion of it with the chords, because there's a lot of melody going on. So all you need to know for this one is B minor, G, D, and A. And that'll get you the part that everybody knows from the recordings. So you're going to start with the B minor, making sure we're barring that top part on the second fret. So we're B minor, then we're going to go to G, then we're going to go back to the B minor. Kind of like our little home base. Then we're gonna move 3 fingers to the second fret for D, and then we're gonna finish it out on A. And then we start the pattern over again, and it's literally that same pattern for the entire song, even the bridge, everything. Not that anybody hears the bridge, because we only hear about 15 seconds of the song. So we're gonna try that with just the pattern in time, and then we'll try to add the melody on top of it with some doodly doodly doos, because there's no words to the song, it's instrumental. So I do sort of around here, 1, 2, ready, and that's sort of the tempo that I do, and I'm doing a strum that is sort of a variant of the down, down, up, up, down, up. You could probably use that if you wanted to. I believe I'm doing a down, chuck, up, chuck up. I'm using a variant of that one. So maybe I'll have a whole tutorial of just chucking and strumming. Let me know in the comments if you're interested in any of the strum patterns that I'm using. So 1, 2, ready, and B minor, B minor, and G, and G, back to B minor, back to D, and up to A. And you repeat that and repeat it. Now I'm doing a weird pattern that I don't think I've ever actually done that pattern with it. So I'm gonna do the one that I'm used to playing with it when I wanna get it out of my head. And we'll add the melody on top of that. So as soon as you hear the melody, you're gonna know which one I'm talking about. One, two, three, four. Ba, 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 da, 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 ba, ba, da, ba, ba, da, da, ba, ba, da, di, ba, da, da, ba, ba, da, ba, 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 da. And so it just keeps going and going. That one's kind of fun. Would anyone be interested in me doing that as like a full cover? I think I might want to do that as a full cover. Put in the comments if you're interested in that one or any of the ones that I've done so far. We have to move on to number six. Number six is another really easy one. Maybe I put it in the middle to give us a little breather. Number six is kind of on the opposite side of the oops, because they're the same kind of viral video. You start slummed and then you end glammed. And that is the Bippity Boppity Boo song. Of course, everybody knows this from Cinderella. That's where it's made famous from. So finding chords for it was pretty simple. And for the most part, Disney chords are pretty simple because they wanted people to be able to play them and sing them and enjoy them and spread the good word and advertising of Disney. So Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo, all you need to know for chords is truly two. C and G7, and that's pretty easy on ukulele. So C is just a regular old C chord, four finger or three finger on that third fret last string. And then G7 is a little bit more complicated, but not too bad. It's one of my favorite chords. So all you need are C and G7, and you basically just strum away and add the words to it. The words, if you don't know, are salakadula menchikabula bippity bappity boo. Put them together and what have you got? You've got someone who's suddenly wearing like a lot of makeup and wearing very tight clothing, usually high-waisted, things like that. And I have no shade on those people. So we'll try this with chords first. I don't really know what strumming pattern I'm gonna use, but here we go. One, two, ready, and. C, C, G7, 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 C, something like that. So we're gonna try, it'll make more sense with the words, I believe. One, two, ready, and. Salakadula, magicabula, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Put them together and what have you got? Bibbidi bobbidi boo. Now they don't actually go through the entire phrase like that. Like literally all you get is put them together and what have you got? Maybe even that far. And then it starts in with some like crazy bass thing happening. I don't know. And like we're supposed to feel the transformation. So that's Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo. Number seven. We're already up to number seven. Number seven is Pretty Girl, which if you don't know this song, you probably know the viral video because it involves stairs. It's usually two or more people going up the stairs doing a walking man. Or no, is it what? No, they're running. It's a running man, because walking men would just be walking, but a running man is a running man. So Pretty Girl is actually the one that they use is a remix of a song that's much slower by an artist named Maggie Lindemann. Now, I'm going to change the lyrics slightly because it involves an F-bomb, and I'm a public school teacher, therefore I'd like to keep my job. So I'm gonna alter the lyrics just a little bit. Hope you don't mind. The chords that you need for Pretty Girl are G, C, E minor, and D. So far, all the chords we've already done, so nothing new here. All you need is the G. So let's start with G. There's our G. You do C, then you do E minor. So you're gonna take three fingers down, one on each fret going bing, bang, boom. And then you're going to move it to D. So three fingers up on that second fret. And we just basically repeat that. And I'm gonna do definitely some kind of chucking strum with this. That's kind of when it's gonna give it that remixed feel that they use in the videos. We'll do just the strumming first. One, two, ready, and G, and C, E minor, and D, and G, and C, E minor. just end it on the tonic, end it on that G. By the way, if you're ever frustrated with me going too fast with the chucking, or you just want to do a simpler strum, you can do that. G, C, you don't have to do the chucking strum, but I feel like I'm just trying to give you an idea of how this could sound on ukulele, as most similar to the feel that they give on TikTok. If we add the words, let's see what those words are. I'm gonna have to stare at the screen now. All right, so with the words, here we go. One, two, and. I can swear, I can joke, I say what's on my mind. If I drink, if I smoke, I keep up with the guys, and you see me holding up my middle finger to the world. Keep your ribbons and your pearls, 'cause I'm not just a pretty girl. She ain't just a pretty girl. And now I'm just whatever. So that is not the original key, by the way. The original key is a little stranger. I think it's F, which means there's a B flat and an E flat and a G minor and an F. Yeah, the original key is F. Maybe I'll put like little notes on things so that you know down in the description what things are, but ain't nobody really interested in playing in that key on ukulele, so I made it a little simpler and moved it to G, which is good for me to sing. And if you don't like that, then you can just go play it in the original key. Yeah, we're gonna move on to number eight. Number eight. Number eight is Lose Control by Medusa and Beck Hill. So I don't know who either of those people are, which probably makes me sound really old, or I don't know. So this video, I'm trying to remember what the viralness of this one was, but I did get the song stuck in my head a lot. Okay, so the chords that you need for this one are going to be B minor, and you could make that a B minor 7, but I think B minor sounds best. You also need an E minor 7 and a G major 7, my personal favorite. So we're gonna start with that B minor. This is, you guys are gonna get a workout on this B minor, it's all over the place. So B minor, and then we're gonna go to the E minor 7, so two little fingers on opposite, like woo ba ba ba, every other on that second fret. You can refer to the picture. And then we're gonna actually go back to the B minor. And then we're gonna go again to the E minor 7. And then we're gonna change it to the G minor 7, so, or G major 7. So all we're actually doing is adding one more finger in between the two fingers. And it gives it that kind of magic glow that the G major 7 tends to give. I think there's an entire video somewhere about why G major 7 is the best chord on ukulele. Because it is objectively the best chord on ukulele. So once again, we have B minor, we have E major, E minor 7, G major 7. And then you repeat that last part again. B minor, we go back to E minor 7, and then to G major 7. And that's the chorus part of it. And I'm trying to remember what the TikTok viralness was of this one, but the song is so catchy. I don't remember what second mark, I'll probably put it down in the description where this starts in the context of the whole song. So this beginning part starts right in the middle of the refrain or the pre-chorus or whatever you want to call it. And it's a little bit more rubato, which means you kind of just play when you wanna play. And so we're gonna play that B minor and you're gonna sing something. I Need to Know, I think is the name of the phrase. And then you do your E minor 7. Could you be the one to call when I lose control? Now we're gonna go a tempo and I'll count you off. One, two, ready, and B minor. E7 and G major 7. B minor. Move to E minor 7 and G major 7. Now, if we add the lyrics and the melody on top of that, it becomes that thing that you've heard a million times that you didn't know that you knew. So we have
I need to know, could you be the one to call when I lose control?
And then that keeps going and going and going, and that is Lose Control by Medusa and something Hill. Not Faith Hill, certainly not Faith Hill. We are up to number nine. Number nine. Number nine is Falling by Trevor Daniel.
But when I saw you, I felt something I never felt. I'm so sorry, I give you all.
Everything that you need to know for Falling is an F, an E7, A minor, and a C. This one is not in the original key. This is moved down a half step from the original key because no one's really interested in playing G flats on ukulele. I'm not, so therefore I won't. You can't make me. So F, and then we're gonna move that to E7. Then we're gonna go to A minor, and then we're gonna go to C. And then we rinse, repeat. We're just gonna strum, we'll just do a strum for this one, just a nice little quarter strum, maybe a little down up if you're feeling fancy. 1, 2, 3. My last made me feel like I would never try again, but when I saw you, I felt something I'd never felt. Come closer, I'll give you all my love. If you treat me right, baby, I'll give you everything. So that one's kind of like a sweet song on ukulele. I like it a lot better than I like the original on ukulele. So that is Falling by Trevor Daniels. We have reached the end, number 10. So number 10, I think, is one of the best standalone songs on these TikTok viral videos, and that is Say So by Doja Cat. I love this song. Do not be surprised if you see me do an entire cover of this. Now, this is probably the hardest one for lyrics for me, so I'll be staring down at this iPad for sure. But the chords that you need to know for this one are B minor. Are you surprised? B minor. E7, A major 7. There's a new one, and F sharp 7. So we got two new chords on this one. Maybe that's why it's best for last. And this is definitely not in the original key, but the chords aren't too bad, and I think it's actually easiest to play in this key. So we're gonna start with a B minor, shock, and then we're gonna move to an E7. You're gonna get real good at these two chords. And then the A major 7, which is so easy. It's just two fingers, boop, and it's so deliciously, like those notes are right up against each other, and it just sounds so, ooh, it's earthy. I like it. Then we're gonna go to the F sharp 7, which is a distinct difference from this nice comfortable position to the F sharp 7, which is all of those things. I mean, you see, there's complicated things happening over there, which is why it's probably number 10. I've got my pinky on the, my pinky and my forefinger are on the fourth fret, and they're kind of every other there, and then I've got my third finger on the third fret on that lowest string, and then I've got my pointer finger up on the second fret. And so that's your F sharp 7. It's not my favorite chord, but you get used to it. So we're gonna go back to the B minor, back to that E7, and we're gonna go back to the A major 7, and we're gonna go up to that F sharp 7. I'll try to do a simple strum for the first one, and we're just gonna keep going. 1, 2, ready, and B minor, E7, A major 7, F sharp 7, B minor, E7, A major 7, up to that F sharp 7, and that keeps going and going. So then we add a little bit more kick to that strum, and we add the lyrics on top of it, which I will be staring deeply into the face of my iPad because I don't know the words as well as I want to, because I want to know this song by heart. The reason I like this song is because it sounds like disco. And if you know me, disco is my favorite music. And I feel like this is like neo-disco. I love it. Here we go. 1, 2, ready, and.
Day to night to morning, keep with me in the moment. I bet you had I known it, why don't you say so? Didn't even notice, no punches left to roll with. You got to keep me focused, how would you say so?
Oh, how can you not enjoy it? It's so fun. Now, I know I only said 10, but I have like a little bonus one because I play this one if there's ever like a time during this quarantine that I feel sad, and I just really need to express the way I'm feeling, this is the one that I go to, because it gives me just like a little boost, you know, gives me what I need. So we're gonna play a little like name that tune with this one. And if you're a TikToker, you're probably gonna get it. Maybe you'll get it. I don't know. We'll find out. So the chords that you need to know for the mystery TikTok tune are B minor, again with the B minor, G, and A. That's what you need to know. And so I'm gonna play through that, and we're gonna see if you can figure out which song it is that gives me that little lift that I need during this quarantine. Any takers yet? I'm gonna do it, and if you get it, I mean, you better put something in the comments to let me know that you got it based off of that. Maybe I'll do the instrumental. Maybe I'll play it full out, and then we'll see. I'll give you one more. I'm gonna give you one more chance. Don't take advantage of me. I'm already laughing. I can't keep a straight face. So, let's see if you got it right. One, two, here we go. Somebody come get her. She dancing like a stripper. Somebody come get her. She dancing like a stripper.
Somebody come get her. She dancing like a stripper. Somebody come get her. She dancing like a stripper.
I'm going crazy with this quarantine, you guys. All right, that's like my favorite one out of all of them. For sure, it's my favorite one. That is Stripper. I don't even know who the original artist is of that. Maybe if you want to inform me in the comments. I mean, just enlighten me away. I've got nothing to do. So thank you for sticking with me. I hope that those are helpful. I hope that it gets you through, you know, 1 hour of your quarantine, however long this is gonna take. If you end up learning something from this and you post a video, please tag me, because it would like brighten my quarantine so much at this point, because as you know, I'm a teacher. And so I'm not out of a job per se, but the thing that I do, that I like live off of both in spirit and in daytime, is gone. So I'm looking to be teaching. I can't help but to teach and to want to see people doing things with music that make them happy. So please make sure that you tag me and let me know what you think. If you like this video and you want to see more things like this, put it in the comments and then smash the like button. And if you haven't already, definitely make sure that you hit the subscribe button, hit that ding-a-ling bell, because I'm gonna be doing some full version covers of a couple of these. If you put in the comments which one you like, I got all the time in the world to give them a whirl. So make sure that you're doing that. And if you have requests in general or questions about the chords, definitely make sure you let me know. I will have a link down in the bottom for the chords for everything if you need a little reference sheet. And I have a Patreon down in the link below, and if you want to drop me a couple dollars for the stuff that I put on this channel, I would really appreciate it. Until the next one, have a good one, and I will see you on the next one.
It's time for outros and thank yous for watching. Now please like and subscribe. Please validate my existence by coming